Hey everybody, Rob here at eTrailer.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Thule Helium Pro 2 hanging style bike rack on our 2018 Ford EcoSport. Now our Helium Pro bike rack is going to allow us to take up to two bikes to and from the trail, and it's going to alleviate the problem of having to cram our bikes inside of our EcoSport or having to get a bike rack and put it on top of the roof. Because if you're like me and some other people, it's a lot easier to put a bike rack on the back of your car than rather than having to lift them up over your head and then unload them. Now the nice thing is if you do have to take your bike rack out or whenever you take it out to store it, it is going to be extremely lightweight because our Helium Pro is actually made out of aluminum, so it's going to be lightweight, strong, and rust proof. And since our Helium Pro is a hanging style, our bike is going to be held securely at three points of contact. We're going to have two on the top cross tube here and then one on the vertical support. Now the one on the vertical support is going to prevent the bike from swaying too much, preventing that bike-to-bike contact. One nice thing I really like about it is that it truly has included a cable lock, so we can make sure that our bikes are going to be nice and secure and would deter those would-be thieves. But let's go ahead and take our bike off so we can get a closer look. And these straps are going to work really easy. We can just push in on the little lever here, and it'll release the tension, and we can feed the straps out. It's going to be the same thing for all the other straps as well. Once we have all the straps loose, we grab our bike, we can take it off and set it aside. Now with the bike out of the way, we can take a closer look at the cradles that the bike's going to sit in. You can see it has this nice, soft, tight material, so it'll hold onto our bike well, but also not have to worry about any kind of scratches or abrasions on the finish. You also notice it has these little indentions, and that's going to be specifically for our cables that run along the frame, that way they're not going to get pinched or crushed. Another thing I really like about these cradles is the fact that they're going to be spaced 7 inches apart. Now that's going to be the optimal spacing for your bikes, so we shouldn't have to worry about too much of that bike to bike, the handlebars coming in contact, or the pedals. Now the straps are also going to have a nice soft rubber material, which will aid in holding it and gripping the bike well, but again, not have to worry about any kind of scratches or abrasions of the finish. I always like to put these back, even if it is just loosely, just so I don't have to hear them flopping around in the wind when I'm driving down the road. Now, being able to take two bikes with you on the back of your EcoSport is going to be really nice. But as you can see, we're adding quite a bit of space to the back of our EcoSport, and we may not always have that space. So I'd like to give you a few measurements. From the back of our bumper here to the furthest point on our rack, we're going to be adding right about 31 inches. But we don't always have that space. Maybe we need to pull in our garage or pull in a parking space. Well, if we come to the top of the mast here, we'll have a gray lever. If we lift up on that lever, we can actually rotate the arms down, which you can already see it's saving quite a bit of space. If I measure from the same point, we're only going to be adding about 17 inches. So it did make quite a bit of difference. Now, another measurement that's definitely going to come in handy is the ground clearance, because our EcoSport does sit a little close to the ground, so we want to make sure we're not going to be bottoming out. Now, if you look at the hitch, you can see our bike rack is going to come straight out, so we're not losing anything, but at the very back here, it is going to slope up. So at the lowest point, at the back of the mast right about here, we're coming in about 14 inches. So if you have a really steep driveway, you want to be mindful of that whenever you're coming in or backing out. Another thing that I like about our bike rack is I know we've all been in that situation. We get to the trail, we're ready to ride, somebody forgot their water bottle, their helmet, or something else in the back. Well, I don't know about you, but I really don't want to crawl from the front seat all the way to the back, and I really don't want to have to pull out my bike rack if I don't have to. Well, if we come to the bottom of the mast, we can lift up on the same style lever, except this time the whole mast will tilt away. And because of the way our EcoSport hatch opens, we can still open it, but we are going to be limited on how much space we can swing it open. You can see it'll clear our bike rack all the way to about here. then we are going to come in contact with the mass pretty close. But as you can see, there's still plenty of room to get in here. I can get all the way over towards the driver's side, get behind the door, get whatever I need to. Then we can close everything up. Then we just simply lift the bike rack back up, and you can hear it click and lock back into place. Now, one thing you're really going to like about the bike rack is whenever we do put it in or take it out, it's going to be completely tool-free. Tooley's going to use this snug-tight stinger here to secure everything. And you'll see, once we put our bike rack in, this little lever is just going to catch the hitch pin hole and secure it down. But on the other side, you'll notice we're going to have this large knob. And what that's going to do is it's going to take all the slop, slack, and play out of the receiver tube, so when we're driving down the road, we don't have that annoying rattling sound. In fact, if I grab the bike rack and start shaking, the entire car is going to move because there's no play inside the receiver tube. But another nice feature is the fact that our Helium Pro here is going to work with 1¼-inch hitches like we have here, but it's also going to work with 2-inch hitches with a sleeve that we can put on later. Now, you'll notice that on top of the knob, we're going to have this metal lock core. Well, that makes it so nobody can tamper with this knob and loosen up the bike rack so they can take it out. But what's really nice is that it is going to be keyed alike to the cable lock, so we don't have to worry about one lock to keep the bike rack secure to our car, and then our bikes secure to our bike rack.
This is our test course. Let's start with the slalom. This shows side-to-side action, such as turning corners or evasive maneuvering. Then, onto our alternating speed bumps. This shows twisting action, such as hitting curbs, potholes, road debris, or even uneven pavement. Last of all, the solid speed bumps. This shows up and down action, such as driving through a parking lot or parking garage, or driving in and out of a driveway.
With all that being said, again, I'm Rob here at eTrailer.com, and that'll finish up your look at the Thule Helium Pro 2-hanging style bike rack on our 2018 Ford EcoSport.